show is in its fourth year now, and we've been proud to be a founding partner of the Big Data London show, and we're so proud to announce some of the big advancements that we've done in our Palladium technology, and we couldn't resist but give a sneak preview.
We expected to get 1,500 people in year one. We ended up with over 3,000 first time, so we knew we were onto something.
Well, I think it's the flagship data and analytics conference for the UK now. I'm actually beginning to think this is one of the fastest growing shows in the whole of Europe. It's aimed at bringing people together who are trying to make data and analytics work within their enterprise.
We knew that data and analytics was getting more and more important, and it's just grown and grown and grown ever since.
When we sit down in front of data, we do it because we're trying to make some sort of decision. Universally, no one sits down in front of data and just says, hey, I've got nothing better to do, I'm gonna look at some pretty pictures. So the name of the presentation is 99% of your data is worthless, but which 99%? It's really designed to get people to think about and understand that business decision making does not need all the data, and in particular, the areas that we work in.
Guy's gonna go for an unofficial world record for the fastest created and ingested data warehouse in the world, and hopefully complete it in less than 5 minutes.
We can reduce the amount of effort it takes to do the analysis of this data without losing insight. That would be a massive win for us internally as a cost.
I don't think I've met an exec yet at the C level who doesn't want it shorter, sooner, faster.
You need to be mindful of things like partnerships. You won't be able to do everything yourself. If you're going to scale this thing, funnily enough, you're going to find that there's other people like Datalytics that you're going to need to work with to take this thing to market.
There's a number of components being built by different teams. And I think the challenge is, how do you coordinate that? How does it come together? That's where DataOps has a role. It's a different way of thinking. People have to understand that if they're going to implement that successfully.